Joe De Blasi for the Varsity Sports Network. We are at Archbishop Curley, the new head lacrosse coach and very familiar to all lacrosse fans, not just in this area, but probably across the nation, John Tucker, who graduated from Curley in 1979, a member of the U.S. Lacrosse Hall of Fame, member of the National Lacrosse Hall of Fame, brings an awful lot to the program here. I know you got to be excited about it. Tell me how you feel being named the coach here at Curley.
Real excited, Joe. It's certainly something that is, if you look at kind of a storybook ending to, you know, my coaching career, it's to be able to come back here and help these young guys and, you know, hopefully reach new heights, to take over for a program that's done well, and, you know, hopefully that we can kind of restore the glory to the program and get after some teams. And you know, our goal ultimately is to move up into the A conference. So, you know, we're looking at a plan. We have a plan in place, and it's going to take a little time, but I'm sure that we'll get it done.
Well, I know you have a lot of familiarity with the A conference. Yeah. Your son Ryan had an unbelievable year, especially in that come from behind victory over Boys Latin in the semifinal game.
Right.
And then Gilman goes on and wins the championship over a very strong Calvert Hall team. And subsequent to that, Ryan makes the under-19 national team.
Right.
Talk about the thrill of that and how you feel about that.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's indescribable to be his dad. And we have another young guy, son who's going to be a senior at Gilman. You know, he's a defenseman, so he hasn't quite reached that level, but I think he's on his way. Ryan, you know, I mean, he's had an unbelievable career. You know, soccer championship, two lacrosse championships, and to be selected to represent his country is a dream come true. I know for him, Janine and I have done tried to really stay away from pushing him into the sport, and he's kind of really found that passion on his own. But he's a tremendous player, big kid, and you know, hopefully staying healthy and barring any injuries, I think he should have a pretty good career down in Virginia. And we're really excited for him. I mean, there's a very bright future. He's a great kid. So we're really, really pleased.
We had the chance to talk to him about going to Virginia, and he can't wait to play on the same team as Steele Stanwyck, who's going to be a senior. He said how much he looked up to him and what a combination that's going to be next year.
Well, you know, we'll see. I mean, Steele's, you know, he's just as good a player as Steele Stanwyck is. He's an even better kid, you know, and if somebody could write a book on how to raise kids, the Stanwyck family has just done a perfect job of, you know, all their kids are just super nice and great athletes, kind, generous people. To be playing with Steele Stanwyck is, I know, a dream of Ryan's. He's looked up to him for a long period of time. For him to go down to Virginia, I'm not sure what his impact will be, but Steele, you know, he's a man amongst boys and intelligent. But I think the biggest thing that we're most pleased by is that he'll have influence on Ryan as a senior captain and a guy who, you know, we really kind of played into our factor of a decision of sending him down there, knowing the senior class that they would have and the kind of kids and quality that Coach Starja represents. I mean, Steele Stanwyck watching out for Ryan is probably our greatest joy.
That's a wonderful words about the Stanwyck family. Let's talk about one more family, the Kelly family in the area, and Frank Kelly's son, Stephen, who made the under-19 national team with your son, Ryan. And in talking to Frank, who I'm going to try to catch up with later this week as well, that you and Frank played against one another at various levels. Tell me a little bit about that.
We did. And, you know, Frank Kelly is a, you know, again, for as nice a guy as he is, and he's an unbelievable competitor. I mean, he is, you wouldn't believe the competitive spirit that he has. And it's transferred down to his children and to Bones, who I know a little bit. He's 2 years removed from Ryan. He's closer to my son Devin's age. But to watch that guy dominate since he's been a young kid has been spectacular. Frank Kelly and I actually ended up playing on the same club team for a long period of time, Maryland Lacrosse Club. And it was really, it was actually an incredible moment to watch our two kids, we were sitting next to one another, and they happened to be on the same team at one time during the U.S. 19 tryouts, doing what we did 25 years ago, where Frank was the face-off guy, and he always dominated, and I happened just to be a wing guy, you know, and he would just give me a signal, and I'd go to a certain spot, and you could always count on Frank to win the ball in certain areas, and to watch Bones and Stephen Kelly to kind of look over Ryan and kind of give him a nod, it really was weird. And Frank kind of looked at me, and I was like, this is just a tremendous flashback to success he has. But, you know, he's done, again, another not only great player, but Stephen Kelly is just a phenomenal kid. So we're really happy. We'll spend the summer with them next year in Finland, and, you know, our sons, we have our sons to thank for that.
John, these are the things that make movies about, so I'm just pleased to be able to have it on our website, the Varsity Sports Network website, with all the things we've discussed today. I can't conclude without also mentioning that you played on the 1984 Johns Hopkins National Championship team, and the things that are going to evolve now, and another Stanwyck's going to be going to Hopkins next year too, Wells.
Yeah.
And a third is coming up through the ranks at Boys Latin, Shaq. And this is, of course, not about the Stanwyck family, but how can you not mention them in the same breath?
No. You know, I think the thing about them, all of them, again, I just echo what a tremendous family they have. You know, we've known the girls when they played, and now Covey. Ryan, Covey, and Wells were all in the same class at Cathedral School at Baltimore prior to Ryan going to Gilman. And they were always good friends and close. And Covey was funny that, you know, they would play schoolyard football, and she was always the quarterback because she was just the best athlete of that group. And that included a lot of really good boy male athletes.
That says
she
a lot. Dominant. Yeah.
Yeah. So Wells is, you know, good friends with Ryan, and you know, I'm really happy for him. You know, it was the only surprising decision, but, you know, he decided to go so close to home. But Johns Hopkins is a great school. You know, certainly happy that he went there. They're getting a heck of a player, great kid. He sees the field well. It's just a really good story for everybody involved. So Wells is happy and content. Covey, Ryan going on to Virginia. It should be a great future for all of them.
It's going to be a good year to follow lacrosse again. Congratulations again on being named head coach here at Archbishop Curley. Wish you nothing but success. Looking forward to a lot of wins and seeing you in the A conference against some of these very familiar names as we go forward.
Yeah, in time. Thank you, Joe.
John, thanks for coming on.
I appreciate it.